Hello students, next we will start our module 4, module 4 chapter 7, and that is wireless communication systems. Okay, in short that is also written as WCS, wireless communication system. So in this chapter we will study these concepts. Okay, first one is the introductory part, then we will get to know about electromagnetic polarization, electromagnetic radiation. The next one is optical properties of radio waves. Next is terrestrial propagation of electromagnetic waves, skip distance, free space path loss, microwave communication systems, and finally about satellite communication systems. Okay, so these are the concepts that we'll cover in our wireless communication system chapter. Okay, let's see the introduction part. Okay, so we know that in our data communication system, a sender is there and a receiver is there. We are communicating data between sender and receiver by means of a transmission medium. Okay, and that transmission medium may be of wired or wireless. Okay, as the name is wired transmission medium, so here a wire or cable is used. Okay, and that is also called as what? Guided media. And in case of wireless transmission medium, no wire or cable is used. Okay, so that is also called as unguided media. So here we will study about what? The wireless transmission medium. How the message or data is communicated from the sender to the receiver without using any form of cable or wire. Okay, and that type of communication system is basically termed as what? Your wireless communication system. So here, see, if a communication system is using what? Wireless transmission mode or media for communication, then it will be termed as what? Wireless communication system. Okay. Next, see the different examples of wireless transmission media. So examples are, first one is radio wave, microwave, infrared. So these are the three most popular wireless transmission media that are used nowadays. Okay. Next thing is that we know that the data should be converted into signal form before being transmitted over the transmission medium. Okay, and that signal is generally termed as what? An electromagnetic signals. That means both electric field and magnetic field is present in that signal. Okay, so in a wireless communication system, an electrical signal must be generated or produced, or you can say emitted, from an antenna. Okay. And that signal should propagate or transmitted through the either Earth atmosphere, or Earth atmosphere is called as air, or free space, that is also called as vacuum. Okay, and it should be received or captured by another antenna that is present at the receiver side. So see in this diagram, this one is what? Your sender side antenna. This one is what? Your receiver side antenna. So the sender side antenna is producing the signal, and that signal is passing through the air or vacuum, that is what? Our wireless media. No cable or wire is used there. And that signal at the receiver side, it is received or captured by the receiver antenna. Next, see, our wireless medium are called as what? Unguided medium. Why that is called the unguided medium? No guide or no direction is there. It depends upon two factors. First thing is that the wireless signals depends on the signal emission direction. The direction in which signal is produced or generated, okay, it depends upon that thing. And second one is what? The signals may face some obstacles during its propagation. Okay, so that's why the wireless medium is called unguided medium. Okay, it depends upon the signal emission direction and the obstacle it is facing or encountering during its path of propagation. Next thing is that signals propagating through an unguided transmission medium are available to anyone with a device that is capable of receiving them. Okay, any device can capture the signal you are transmitting. Okay, but that should possess some special characteristics or what? Criteria. Fine. Next one is what? Why we should use wireless media? Okay, so first thing is that if the sender or that is called transmitter receiver are present at a long distance apart, okay, And second thing is that if the sender device and the receiver device are mobile, mobile means the movable nature, then at that moment the metallic cable or optical fiber cable is not possible to use. Okay, because for a long distance transmission you need a very high length cable, so it will be more expensive. Okay, and practically it is also not possible to use the cable for the long distance transmission. So that's why we should use some form of wireless media like free space or earth atmosphere. Okay, next thing is that basically your free space propagation of electromagnetic waves is called as what? RF propagation, or that is called radio frequency propagation. Okay, and simply that is also called as what? Radio propagation. Okay, generally your free space implies what? Vacuum. Okay, but in our data communication system, most often the earth atmosphere is called as what? Free space propagation. But in communication engineering, there is a slight difference between what? Earth atmosphere and vacuum. While a signal is transmitted through earth atmosphere, it will encounter some type of losses. Okay, but inside vacuum, no loss is introduced. Okay, no loss is there. Then in earth atmosphere, the signal may face some optical phenomenon. Okay, but that is not possible in case of vacuum. Okay, in earth atmosphere, optical phenomenon means that may be reflection, refraction, diffraction or interference. These are the optical phenomena that is not possible in case of vacuum. Okay, next we will see the characteristics or features of radio waves. Okay, first thing is that radio wave is a form of what? Wireless media. Okay, and that is one type of electromagnetic wave like light. Okay, and the radio waves that is transmitted or propagated through the free space, and it will move in a straight line direction from the sender side to the receiver side, and the velocity of radio wave is 3 × 10⁸ meter per second. Okay, next let's see other forms of electromagnetic waves. Besides radio wave, other forms of electromagnetic waves are infrared, ultraviolet, x-rays, gamma rays, etc. Okay, next we'll see what are the conditions for radio wave propagation. Okay, first thing is that the signal energy from the sender side, it must be radiated from the source. Okay, second one is what? That signal must be directed towards the receiver, not to the other side. Okay, the signal must be directed towards the what? Receiver. Okay, and after reaching at the receiver side, third one is what? That signal energy must be captured at the receiving end. So these are the three conditions for radio wave propagation. Next thing is that what are the different examples of wireless communication system? So wireless communication systems are used in these areas. First one is what? It is used in broadcast radio systems. Okay, while the message signal is broadcasted to a large group of audience like commercial FM radio, AM radio or television, their wireless communication system is used. Okay, second example is what? Two-way mobile radio. Okay, cellular telephone and terrestrial and satellite microwave radio system, your wireless communication systems are used. Okay, that's all. Thank you.